Jesus because I was grew in Catholic school, but a lot of things that is not make sense to me. That's why I look for Islam, and I love Islam, but I don't like the Muslim people in Indonesia. And I love dogs as a pet. So my question is actually, why they can't tell me I'm not a Muslim just because I have dogs as my pet? And I'm still learning, but they don't have any rights to judge me. Would you mind to explain? Because I didn't find anything in the Quran that says it's haram to pet a dog. And instead, I found that the history of a lot of the prophets are the shepherds, so they also have dogs to help them, including, if I'm not mistaken, correct me if I'm wrong, including the prophets Muhammad.
Okay, so the question?
So the question is, is it really is a harm to pet a dog? And then can they judge me as not a Muslim just because I love the dogs and pet the dogs?
So what's the background? Are you a Catholic? Are you a Christian? Or are you a Muslim? Or?
No, I believe I'm Islam. But if you say that Muslim is totally...
So were you born in a Muslim family, sister?
But I don't think they really...
So were you born in a Muslim family?
Yes.
You were born in a Muslim family, and you are a Muslim. But you have got special thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
Sister, we prefer that non-Muslims should be given the first chance. But since you have come, I will answer your question. I declare the volunteers that before anyone asks a question, please check whether there are Muslims or non-Muslims. I believe you are born in a Muslim family, and you are a Muslim, right?
I believe I am Muslim, but they say that I am not Muslim.
No, no. But you believe you are Muslim, correct? But just because you keep dogs as pets, and the prophet earlier said dogs to take care of the sheep, of the cattle. So, the other people say you are not a Muslim. Sister, in Islam, keeping dog is prohibited in your house as a pet. But keeping a dog for hunting is no problem. As a dog in your house, no problem. What the prophet used to say dogs was to keep the flock and the cattle together, that is permitted. So if you use dog for hunting, it's allowed. To take care of the cattle, it's allowed. To keep a dog to guard your house outside is allowed. But in the house aspect, it is not private. It is private, sister. It is private because the fit of the dog is unclean. And today, even science tells us that the saliva of the dog, there are various diseases that can be acquired. And one of them is hydrophobia. Hydrophobia means fearing of water. So Islamically, keeping a dog as a pet is wrong. Now, if you keep a dog and you believe it is wrong, that's a different question. You may not be a practicing Muslim. But someone to say, you are not a Muslim, that's a very strong statement. Just because one person doesn't follow some portion of the Quran or some portion of the Hadith, as long as you believe there is one God, and you believe Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God, as long as you don't look up, you cannot be called a non-Muslim. As long as you agree, you have to agree what is mentioned by the Prophet. That keeping dogs is prohibited because it leads to various diseases. Keeping a dog. You can keep him to guard your house, you can keep him to protect your cattle, no problem. But Islamically, keeping a dog is wrong. That's the reason the Prophet said that if the dog licks any vessel, you have to scrub it 3 times with earth. And today science says that even normally if you wash a vessel with the dog has licked, the germ died up there. Only if you clean it with the earth, does it go away. So imagine a dog coming into your house and he licks everywhere, he licks you, and you are playing in the house. So what natural it is filthy. So economically to keep a dog as a pet in your house is prohibited. Hope that answers the question.
But outside, it's okay, right?
Outside, I talk for hunting, for protection, not for the pet.
For guarding the house.
Guarding the house, no problem. But not for your parents to lick you.
Yes.
Or to lick you.
If it's passed
up. If you pass, you pass the head. Because the tongue cannot reach the head. So if you pass, you only pass the head. Because the tongue of the dog cannot reach the head.
Yes.
Hope that answers the question.
Thank you.
No problem.
My question is about Trinity. I agree with your statement that in Bible, now I think that there is Trinity. But I found that in Genesis 1:26, then God said, "Let us make man in our image." That means a plural of both. That used in Genesis, that is us. It's more than one person or entity in there. And then Jesus came and Matthew 20:19, he said, "Baptizing them in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit." It's the three of what Jesus said to Baptist is referred to us in Genesis 1:26. Thank you.
The brother asked a question that he knows that the word Trinity is not there in the Bible, but why does God refer to us? And in the Gospel of Matthew, that baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Brother, as you rightly said, the word Trinity doesn't exist anywhere in the Bible, but in then the Quran. Quran says in Surah Nisa, chapter 4, verse number 171. It says, "Allah Ta'ala Salasa." Don't say Trinity. In Tawheerul Lakum, this is top and better for you. And further mentioned in Maida chapter 5, verse 73, "Let us suffer the Zina Kalu in Allah Ta'ala Salasa." They have been put those who say that believe in three in one God. So the word Trinity is there in the Quran saying don't say Trinity. But the word Trinity exists nowhere in the Bible. The closest to the concept of Trinity is the first epistle of John, chapter number 5, verse number 7, which says, "For there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, and these three are one." This statement, "these three are one," is only once in the Bible, first epistle of John, chapter number 5, verse number 7, and this has been thrown out from the Revised Standard Version as an interpolation, as a concoction, as a fabrication by 32 Christian scholars, but by 50 different doctrinal denominations. They say that this word was an interpolation, it's a fabrication, it's a concoction. So the closest to Trinity has been thrown out. Even the word of Matthew, said baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. It doesn't say they are one. And the question, why does it say us? Us is true. Even in the Quran, Allah says, "Nahnu" means me. So in Arabic and in Hebrew and the Semitic languages, there are two types of plural. In most of the languages, including English, one is the plural of number and the other plural of respect. When the Queen of England she says, "We would like to see." She doesn't say, "I would like to see." So this is not the plural of number. It's the plural of respect. So Almighty God in the Quran also says, "Nahnu." In Arabic means we. It's the royal plural. Same thing in the Bible. It's the royal plural. It's not plural of number. Hope that answers the question.
Okay, thank you. Can I ask one more question?
Brother, we just see that if there is time, we can go behind the cube of the other members.
It's about teaching of Jesus.
Give others a chance and you can come back.
Thank you for the time.
You're most welcome. Now, since the time is running short, I'd like to ask that are there any non-Muslims? How many non-Muslims would like to ask the question? In the better side, how many non-Muslims are pending? How many are pending? Can the volunteers count and tell me?
Probably, itong mga non-Muslim yang mau bertanya di situ.
Only non-Muslims are pending.
Panitia, coba dihitung dan dihitung.
Just microphone, only non-Muslims are pending.
Masyaallah.
And the microphone. How many non-Muslims are pending would like to ask the question? And the second microphone from the gents.
Non-Muslim, 12
in the one microphone.
Yeah.
In the second microphone. In the second microphone of the brothers.
Ada mic lain yang ada non-Muslim. Panitia tolong. Panitia tolong cek.
How many non-Muslim sisters are pending?
One side.
How many non-Muslim sisters would like to ask a question are pending?
One girl. Only one.
One girl. And the other microphone?
Yang di atas. Yang di atas ada. Okay, no.
Only one. I would like to ask that among the 12 brothers would like to ask a question. And the sister, who is convinced about Islam and would like to accept Islam. Please raise your hand. Among the 12 brothers that are there, who would like to accept Islam? Can you raise your hand? Can you guys please?
Dari antara yang mau bertanya non-Muslim itu, berapa yang mau masuk Islam, mau menerima Islam? Ada berapa?
Masa, how many ada?
Berapa banyak? Bapak Maritia, tolong dihitung.
How many? Dia
tolong dihitung.
Please just
one
ask a question.
Are there any other sisters who would like to give the shout out?
No, just ask a question.
Are there any other sister, non-Muslim sister, who would like to accept Islam? No.
No.
Okay, from the brothers, there are 7 brothers who would like to give the shout out. Can the 7 come on the microphone, please? Because we're running short of time, it's already 1:15. The time we start for, we'd like all the 7 brothers, if they can come front on the microphone.
Silakan untuk kuncinya, maju menuju microphone untuk bersama-sama.
If there are any sisters who would like to give the shahada, they are most welcome to come on the microphone.
Kalau ada wanita yang mau mengucapkan syahadat, menyatakan syahadat, silakan mendekati microphone.
Are there any sisters who would like to give the shahada, please ask them to come on the microphone. Any sisters, non-Muslim?
No one.
Okay, please may I know the name of all the 7 brothers who'd like to give the shahada. Can you mention your name one by one, please?
Saya dan nama satu-satu.
My name, Matas. Masyaallah. Second brother.
My name is Reynaldi.
Masyaallah. Third brother.
My name is Daniel.
Masyaallah. Third brother. Masyaallah. Third brother.
Eka.
Third brother.
My name is Rio.
Masyaallah. Sixth.
My name is Reza.
Masyaallah. Seventh. Seventh brother.
Yang ketujuh ada.
Seventh brother.
Hanya enam. Enam ya. Only six.
Six ada atau enam ada? Hanya ada six atau seven?
Enam atau tujuh.
Muslims and would like to accept Islam. Yes?
Yes,
anyone forcing you to accept Islam?
No.
Are you doing out of your own free will?
Yes.
I understand in Arabic and all seven can repeat because the time is short. You have to end the session. I said Arabic and you can repeat it. Ashadu.
Ashadu.
All together, all seven together. Ashadu. Allah.
Allah.
Ilaha. Illallah.
Illallah.
Wa ashadu.
أن
محمدا
عبده
ورسوله
are
there witness
that
there is no God
but Allah
and Prophet Muhammad
is
the messenger
and
servant
of Allah.
That may he grant all seven of you Jannah, may he give you Hidayah, may he give you more knowledge so that you can spread the deen and convey the message to your friend. I request all the Muslim brothers and sisters, whenever any non-Muslim accepts Islam, you open him and her, open your arms and your heart for them, take care of them, love them, respect them, and solve the problem. It's the duty of us Muslims to take care of the new Muslim. It's the duty. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that may he give guidance to more people. And I would like to thank, I'm sorry because we're running late and we have to end the session. People have been telling me since a long time they have already extended. And I would like to thank the organizers and thank the mayor of the Kasi and for giving us the stadium for such a long period. And I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and may he give us more.